some exciting things from classes and clubs inside the school.
And also outside with our teams.
Good morning, Staples. Good morning, Staples. It's Wednesday, October 9th. I'm Hannah Foley.
And I'm Tim Schroder. Up until this week, we've been bringing you shows that have been produced by both TV classes.
But starting with today's show, our class will be putting Wednesday's show together on our own.
And our friends in Period 2 will be bringing you Thursday's show.
We'll start with the pledge. Would you all please rise?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
First off, let's check in with Mr. Neenan to find out today's tweet.
Staples, day 30. If you could send President Obama a tweet that you knew he would read and consider, what would you say?
Thanks, Mr. Neenan. Next, let's look at a few classes around Staples. We'll start with a science class that changes things from day to night and from inside to outside. Watch this and you'll see what I mean.
Good morning, Staples. This morning we have a story about Miss Veigas and her astronomy class using a planetarium. Here is our interview.
Okay, so what sort of things do you use this dome for?
This dome we use in the solar system astronomy class and the stars and galaxies and the universe class. So solar system is in the fall, stars and galaxies is in the spring. This is an inflatable planetarium. So if you've maybe ever been to the Hayden Planetarium or the planetarium at the Small Science Museum in Bridgeport, it's like that, only portable.
Okay.
So we bring it down here because it's the only place with tall enough ceilings. And there's a projector in the center inside with little canisters that I can put on top that will project different things on the dome. So I can project just stars, or I can project the stars with Greek mythology drawn on top of them. And we talk about how to navigate your way from one constellation to another in the night sky.
How long have you had this for, the school?
Well, I started teaching here 6 years ago, and they had it here. So as long as I've been teaching here.
Okay, thank you very much.
I guess you never know what you will find in Staples. Have a great morning, everybody.
Next, we'll travel to the art wing to find out more about the mural class, as well as a pretty exceptional feat by their teacher.
Hey Staples, what's up? Tim Schroder here. Today, we're going to be interviewing Miss Wright about the mural painting class going on at Staples right now. Here's our interview.
So what is mural painting?
Mural painting is exactly what it sounds like. And mural painting, we are just painting on a larger scale. So we are taking all the initial painting techniques and learning those. And then what we're going to do is design for the client. Our client here, as you would see, was the art hallways. So we kind of got background and information from the art teachers to produce these. And then the students design them. And then we, as a group, as a team, paint them. Not one person paints one mural. We switch back and forth. Everybody gets a hand putting their touch on mural for murals. We go to the World Language Hallway. You'll see the murals that were produced. And the client wanted murals having to do with the classes they taught. So they teach, for say, Spanish, Italian, French, Chinese. That's the murals we focused on. We focused on one for each language that they taught. And if you go in the hallway, you'll see that they're all represented there. After that, we had a list of clients. We've produced for the PE department, we've produced for the art hallway, for music, for the cafeteria, and we're still working on one that's gonna go in the hallway near the cafeteria that's a Unity mural. Just not quite finished, it's almost there. There's no prerequisites for mural painting. We learn all the basic painting techniques first part of the course. Then we design the murals as per what client we're going to have. So this semester is orchestra, Ms. Valovich. So they're designing, what she wanted was a cross between two inspirational artists, Peter Max and Salvador Dali. So the students are right now working on researching Salvador Dali and Peter Max. And then they're going to work on the actual designs, and we'll show her to make sure she likes the design and the color schemes. And once one is chosen, each student will have a say in how they want the mural to look. We'll have her opinion, and then the students vote to decide which one we're going to choose and the way it's going to look. We make a small template, exact replica of the size, so if the mural is 16 feet by 8 feet, we have 16 inches by 8 inches templates. And then it gets reproduced on the wall, either with an overhead or with a grid, and then the students paint it.
So Miss Wright, you definitely ran a 50-mile trail race, and a lot of Staples students would want to know how that was and the situation behind that.
Well, it's a long ways. No one had ever told me that it was really a long ways. My husband and I ran it together. We stayed together. The training's the hard part. You got to put in a lot of mileage to finish a 50-mile trail race. And we picked one that was during vacation, spring break last year, so that we had time to rest afterwards. It was through the woods, all rocks, roots, trees, and it was run on the Battle of Bull Run. So we ran where the Battle of Bull Run took place, which was very interesting. And it was a blast. It was a lot of fun. And I will do one again, but right now I'm focusing on marathons.
Team Westport is hosting viewings of PBS's Eyes on the Prize on Thursdays at the library. They show an episode, and then there's a moderated discussion. This Thursday, they will be screening an episode called Power, and the moderator will be Denise Davidoff, formerly of the Unitarian Universalist Association.
By the way, in 2 weeks on October 24th, the moderator will be our own Miss Shager. Much more info to follow.
We'll transition into our sports report with an announcement of a fun run that is being sponsored by the Save the Children Club, and will be featuring members of many of our teams.
On Tuesday, October 22nd, the Save the Children Club wants to get as many students on the football field as possible. The goal is to raise awareness of the issues facing malnourished children in the U.S. and around the world. It's just 2 laps around the SHS track, and participation is free. You can run or walk, whatever you choose.
To help encourage participation, 9 local sponsors have pledged their support, giving us product donations ranging from $25 to $500. The football team, cross country, girls soccer, and cheerleading teams have already signed up.
Each runner will receive a certificate of participation and a Save the Children Club bracelet. In addition, we are asking everyone to pre-register by emailing sablesaware@gmail.com with your name as the subject.
Come join us on Tuesday, October 22nd at 2:30 for 2 laps around the track. Just showing up shows you care.
I hope to see you all at the awareness run.
Thanks. On tomorrow's show, by the way, you see some of the same people you just saw. They are putting together a feature on our undefeated girls track team.
The official start of our sports report today is all wet. Yeah, we're starting off in the pool. First off, Darrell Wiggins interviewed water polo captain Tyler Crowder about how the early part of the season is going.
I'm Darrell Wiggins, and I will be interviewing Tyler Crowder, the water polo captain, about this upcoming season.
The team's looking really well this year. We have 4 returning starters, myself, fellow captain Mike DeLuca, senior Jeff Burns, and junior Max Weimer. We also have some kids returning after not playing for a couple years, Tommy Aldridge. He's picked up the sport again pretty quickly. And then we also have a lot of kids from last year, like JT Reichlin. It also shows that we have a lot of depth towards the team, so in case anyone gets injured or needs to step up, the coaches can put them in without having to worry about if they know how to play or not.
So Tyler, what are some expectations for the team this year?
We are a 3-time Hawkins Tournament champions, which is a tournament at the end of every season that Hawkins School, which is a preparatory school, boarding school in Connecticut that holds a water polo tournament and Staples for the past few years, we've won it, and now we want to make it a 4-time defending champion.
What is some advice for those kids that maybe want to try out for the team?
Just to come out and talk to, anybody who plays a sport. They'll tell you it's a awesome, exciting sport. 7-minute quarters, very, very intense play. It's a sport that you've never seen. It combines swimming with essentially football. We have a lot of contact, like football. We also combine the swimming skills of swimming, like I said, so it's very intense, very vigorous. It's very exciting. The clock never stops unless it's like the last 2 minutes of the fourth quarter. But if anyone wants to come out and watch an exciting game, then water polo is the right sport to come watch, or water polo is the right sport to try out. And for all those guys, who are now on, who are now freshmen or sophomores who are just starting the program, you know, stick with it, you guys. You guys will love it for the next 2 years or 3 years. And for all you guys that want to come out and try it, just come out and talk to me and Mike, and we'll love to have you on the team.
Thanks, guys. Now, here's a video that Aaron and Hannah put together on our girls' swim team.
There's something I want. Put money in time. $1 million bills. And the tick, 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 tick. There's nothing more cool than only 9 lives. Unlimited spots. But do the trick, 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 trick.
We're super excited for this season. All the girls have so much potential, and we're undefeated.
Now let's move to the field, soccer field first. Here's our weekly boys soccer update.
Last Thursday against the 2012 state champs Norwalk, the Wreckers pulled off a 2-0 victory. Goals came off a top shelf volley from co-captain Jack Scott and a rebound by Charlie Leonard.
Although the boys soccer team only had one game this week, they're tied for first in the FCAC with Greenwich and Stanford.
This Saturday, Staples Soccer is one of its toughest games of the season against Greenwich. If you're not able to go, in order to get live updates, follow Staples Soccer 1 on Twitter.
For the girls' side today, we feature an up-and-coming soccer star who is starting on varsity in her freshman year.
Good morning, Staples. I'm Greg Freiser of Will O'Halloran. We went around Staples and looked for freshman varsity players. This week, we interviewed Lydia Shaw. Let's go to Will with the story.
I'm here with Lydia Shaw, a forward on varsity soccer. Lydia, what's it like being a freshman on varsity soccer?
It's definitely fun because you get to be on a team with a lot of the older kids in the school.
Being a freshman, do you feel as though you have any higher expectations?
I think there's higher expectations and having to work harder, and I guess it's definitely a higher level of play. So
far in the soccer season, how have the seniors and juniors treated you?
They've all treated me really well. We all get along really great.
Thanks, Will, and a special thanks to Lydia. Make sure you go check out the girls' varsity soccer game at 4 p.m. at Staples against Greenwich. Back to the hosts.
Speaking of girls' sports, our volleyball team is a finalist for the Overtime Team of the Week. They need your help. Go to Facebook and search for the Rudin Report, and then vote for Staples Volleyball.
Speaking of voting online, last week Justin asked you all to vote for Coach P in the USA Today poll of top coaches. We are filming this on Monday afternoon, and the contest ends Tuesday.
But on last check, Coach P was in a virtual tie for top coach in the state with Coach Marinelli of New Canaan.
Congratulations to USA Today for recognizing what we all know, that we have the best football coach in the state right here at Staples.
And his team looked pretty good last Friday, too, defeating Stanford 41-14. Patrick Lesh ran for 264 yards and 3 touchdowns, including this one.
One of the plays of the game was Teddy Coogan's spectacular one-handed catch and 61-yard score. It was captured in this photo sequence by Chris Greer of the Rudin Report. You know, the one you're all going to go on Facebook to vote for our volleyball team.
A Amazing play, Teddy.
With three wins in a row, the Wreckers are home under our Friday night lights for the next 3 weeks.
This Friday, they take on Fairfield Ludlow with a kickoff at 7.
That's it for us today. The Period 2 class will be here tomorrow with their first solo show.
We mentioned our volleyball team a couple of times today. On tomorrow's show, Remy from Period 2 is putting a music video together about the team.
Should be good.
Bye. Bye.
Wednesday. So to speak.